Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from the BBC, Formula One presenter, Lee McKenzie.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure the last time I saw many of you was in Paris when the P1 was presented as a design study. Well, the reaction from all of you was just overwhelming. So the production car that you see here is little changed, which pleases me and I'm sure makes most of you very happy too. And if you were in Paris, you'll also notice that we've got a stunning new color. Now, McLaren has released some very impressive numbers when it comes to this car. So please welcome onto the stage, Ron Dennis. Ron, great to see you at your second International Motor Show. Now, this is the third car to come from McLaren Automotive in just 2 years, the McLaren P1.
Absolutely. We're on target. When we formed the company, we said we'd bring a new model or derivative every year, and so far we've achieved that objective. Of course, this car captures more technology than we've ever brought to any of our production cars. And the key word on this car is exclusivity. Hence the reason why it sits in such close proximity to the LM. Few people realize that in the last 20 years, this is a car that's held, not only held value, but quadrupled in value. If one came onto the market, you would have to pay somewhere around £10 million. So exclusivity is really important to our brand. And this halo car is just that, and full of technology.
We said in Paris that the ultimate test of ability in a car is how quickly it can go around a track, and I suppose the benchmark for that would be the Nordschleife.
Indeed. This is a sort of, tends to be, I would say in performance vehicle terms, this tends to be the benchmark. And of course it's going to set a new benchmark. But how?
Yeah.
I think the important thing to remember is, whilst we've released many figures on this car, I don't think anyone's really grappled with the fact that at 150 miles an hour, we're generating over 600 kilos of downforce. That allows for 2G plus cornering speeds. The whole car is reconfigures itself according to the mode. So you can have full electric, over 120 miles an hour full electric, short range, but in city conditions, over 25 kilometers of range, full electric. Then automatically switch to a very sophisticated hybrid system, which allows for the 170 horsepower of electric power to be fed in a very controlled way to completely eliminate turbo lag. So have a completely linear performance from effectively 0 horsepower to over 900 horsepower with total drivability. And then another switch into track mode, where rear wing deploys, goes into not only it contributing to the 600 kilos of downforce, but actually gives you DRS capability on the straight, which with iPass, another 170 horsepower, to supplement the standard 730 odd horsepower of the production engine. So completely unique, and then you need to stop. Mm-hmm. Stopping, very important.
Some things, people might not want to ever stop.
Yeah, absolutely. But two things that really aid stopping. First of all, the Corsa tyres developed by Pirelli, a very well-known P1 Corsa. But this is, in fact, a unique tyre. It has to be unique because of the downforce, and that coupled to the Akebono brakes, some of the most advanced technology, new material, a carbon-silica mix. After 44,000 kilometres of testing on one set of brakes, the condition was just mind-blowing. So this is a performance vehicle that isn't going to cost the customer endless amounts of top-ups. It is a car that's already heavily developed, outstanding performance, and really breathtaking to drive.
Well, somebody who's getting used to driving McLarens on track is McLaren's newest Formula One recruit. Please put your hands together and welcome onto the stage Sergio Checo Perez. Checo, good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Three pre-season tests in Spain, all ticked off. In 2 weeks' time, the checkered flag will have fallen after the Australian Grand Prix. How have things been going so far?
Yeah, very good. We are looking forward now to start the season. Testing has been obviously good for me to adapt myself into my new team. It's going well. Obviously, still work to do before the first race. The approach hasn't changed. So obviously, we will try to maximize everything we can in this week to arrive very in a very good shape for Melbourne for the first couple of races. I expect to have a difficult start of the season. It will take me time to adapt to the car and to the team, but it will come, and I think I got a great team behind me.
You're about to make all of these people very jealous because you're actually one of the few people in the world who have driven the McLaren P1. What was that like?
It was amazing. I went with Ron to drive the car, and it was just an amazing experience. I think the way it looks, first of all, is beautiful, a beautiful car, but also the way it handles is the closest I've ever been to a Formula One car. The way it brakes, the amount of speed that you can carry into the corner, the amount of downforce that you can produce with a road car, I was quite impressed with the technology, but I think in the end it makes sense, no? Because all the engineers from the Formula One team and from P1, they are working together to build this car, and it's really a massive car and a massive project, which it was a great experience for me to drive.
Big smiles from Sergio, but Ron, I gather that you got involved in the fun.
Absolutely.
Had a go as well.
Absolutely. We were testing the car at Dunsfold. That's the Top Gear test circuit.
Yeah, the Top Gear test track.
Yeah, and I broke the lap record by 10 seconds. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Star and affordable car.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Well, yeah. A reasonably
I'm not so sure the star
is relative, I think.
I'm not so sure about star, but affordable, yes. And anyway, 10 seconds under the record. So I was quite impressed with that. And then go back to the Neusschleifer. It's going to be sub 7 minutes. So it's going to break all the records. I'm a little bit nervous to say it, but I can say with all belief, this is going to be the fastest car in the world. And that includes what's gone before today and what will come after. So we're very, very, very confident. No one's going to get anywhere near the performance of this vehicle. So at a volume of 375, at a very affordable price, best car in the world, it's an absolute bargain and clearly affordable.
Yeah, we've had lots of explosives here today. The world's fastest car, sub 7 minutes in the Nordschleife, and Ron Dennis is the Stig, so we can all go home happy. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks so much for your time coming along here today. Thank you, Ron, and to Sergio. Here's to a wonderful and successful season. And thanks, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you all in Melbourne. Thank you.
Thank you.